What's up, everybody? This is Rob Shack. So today we are going to be continuing along with my Xiahou playthrough. This is the Battle of Chi B in Winter 208 AD.
Wu will fall before my might.
If I might make a suggestion.
You mean this?
Fire. Well, here we go. Thank you all so much for watching. Be sure to like, subscribe, and comment for more Dynasty Warriors 2 gameplay. So, playing as Xiahou Dun, as I just mentioned. Seems pretty good. A lot of enemy or allies. We have a lot of troops, and our morale is really high. So, I know that I played through this level on the Wu side, and you have to play as one guy. Well, one guy is very important. I don't know where the place of prayer is. Like, for all I know, it literally could just be down in the bottom left corner. So maybe I should try to do that. Or I should try to just go take out one guy. Because if I get rid of one guy, like they just can't do anything. So I might do that. If I have a horse, I'm going to run around. But if I don't, then I'm just going to fight with my troops. And we'll see. This game overall is very fun. It's much, much harder than Dynasty Warriors 3 or 4 or any of the other Dynasty Warriors. But it makes sense because they were figuring it all out and they ended up making it freaking impossible. But it's a fun game. I really enjoy it and I hope y'all do too. We're definitely going to start out coming over here, trying to help out this gate of mine. Oh, it's actually an enemy gate. There's Dong Xi, but we're not going to work on him yet. Want to kind of thin out the ranks here a little bit before I start trying to mess with him. Another general coming at me, so this is getting a little bit ridiculous. Right. Gates down. And we're gonna keep trying to figure this out. But I'll probably end up dying a million times, so we'll see. But it's a fun game. It's really stressful to play this game because the enemies are so good and they do so much damage and they can heal at every second and all that. That stuff's all really funny. So we'll see if we can do it. There's a lot of generals up in here. But also, I fortunately have a lot of troops here with me to actually keep me alive. I feel like I would be like, totally dead right now. Why would Yijin even... That general just said... Someone who's literally just hiding in the background was like, he must not get ahead of us. But I'm like, you're not even in the fight, dude. So we're slowly pushing through Tai Chi Shi. Going well overall. Picking up on my little health things. It's archers. The archers in this game are brutal. I'm gonna just go straight for the archers. Yijin kind of got beat up a little bit. Makes me a little nervous. Oh, combo off of Tai Chi Chi. Did, but he freaking survives. I thought you'd get further too, Tai Chi Chi. We'll be right back. Well, we got pretty well this time. It's almost impossible to save Talran on this level. Like, I think I could do it if I literally just focused on him. If you focus only on Talran, you kind of screw over everybody else on your side. So, like, I didn't do it. I didn't feel the need to rescue him. I tried to. Like, I got over there, but he doesn't seem to fight well and just, like, runs into the fight when all of his generals are behind him. So, it's pretty annoying to watch that. But basically what I did was first off, I died once, which is hilarious, but then I went and I basically poked at four fronts that are happening on this level. I went for, my troops are at one of them. I defeated generals at two of them and then ran over to the fourth one and just stayed there because everyone else on that side died, because Talran died and no one goes to help him despite the fact that it pings two of our generals to go help him. They don't actually go and help him. So then I just defeated everything on the right side of the map, and that's it. So it works out. It was definitely an unorthodox way to do it, because I basically become Sauron's troops and just win the whole right side by myself. So it works, but it is just a little bit different. I'm sure I should, and if I can, save him. I just was like, no, just not interested in doing this. So it went well, and it's not that hard of a level. As you start to get stronger, like, the levels get much easier, especially when you've, like, won against a bunch of officers. It seems like they really make you personally much stronger. It's like, I was just rocking generals, like, left and right, and that was pretty awesome. So I don't know if it's harder or easier or not, but it definitely got easier as I defeated generals, and then I felt like I could actually, like, survive on this level somewhat. So it's definitely, like, worth stopping Lu Xun as quickly as possible, stopping Lu Xun and Gan Ning as quickly as possible, because once they defeat Cao Ren, their morale is, like, Gan Ning's was 8. So it was crazy. So we ended up winning, obviously, because we're doing well now, and we'll hope that we can still pull it out, because of course anything is possible in this game, because one general can just keep healing the whole time and it just never works for you. So we'll see. But thank you all for watching, and be sure to like, subscribe, and comment for more, and have a great day.